Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time, we're going to talk about the Mallory 1701 vibrator. This one can run on 6 to 12 volts. It is very, very old, and it is unfortunately defective in the contact set, but not in the vibrator. So we can actually play a little bit with this one, and I need to open it anyway because it's definitely not working. So I do get a little bit of contact responses, but it's definitely not as it was supposed to be. So, but I replaced this one with a new one, and then my unit was working. So that's super good. And this, of course, did prove that this one is not working. And I saved this one so I could make you a video to show you what they are all about. So vibrators, they're actually mechanical switch mode power supplies from the time before transistors. And I'll show you a little bit. Here is a little schematic that I made. So imagine this part here got a little bit of mechanical mass to it, and we connect a positive to that one. And then there is a big fat contact on both sides. So when it oscillates, it hits the two contacts here alternating, right? So here we got a transformer. And the center point of the transformer is connected to minus. So now there is a drive inductor, and there's also some iron and all that kind of stuff in here. And then there's another little contact, a signal contact, and then a minus, a drive voltage for this inductor. So now when you apply voltage for the oscillator part, it will oscillate and it will create a contact, not contact. And because of this mass, there is a fixed frequency and a fixed stable frequency. And because it is, it's oscillating with this mass, there is a very, very close to a perfect 50%. Okay, there's of course dead band, but then the way that it is activating the transformer is optimal for the transformer. Imagine if it was almost most of its time here, right, and then just short here and short here, then you're going to blow up the transformer. You need a symmetric pulse to run your transformer out of saturation. On the other side of the transformer, the secondary sides, you can generate 6 volts and 200 volts, 400 volts, whatever needed for tube radios back in the 50s and 60s for your cars and all sorts of stuff. Yes, car radios back in the 50s and 60s, they had one of these big boys here mounted in a socket because there is a limited lifetime on the contacts. And then you just unplug this and put in a new one, and then you're good to go for another few years. That is how it was. So let's try and play with the vibrator part first. I did look up the connections to the vibrator part, and also I like to show you the contacts. You can see we got two big fat ones here, and then there are all the others, they are a little bit smaller, and that is of course so you can't mount this wrong, because other than that it's symmetric. So it's that one here, and the opposite, that is your oscillator. So let's just try and give it 6 volts and listen to the frequency. Here we go. And it's using only 1 watt of drive power to your switch mode converter. So, I mean, the entire driver, regulator, all that electronics you would normally use you would normally have around a switch mode converter. And imagine back in the 50s or 60s, only using 1 watt to do that, it's not a lot, really. It's not too bad. So let's open this and see if we can prove the contacts are dead. Maybe I could just clean the contacts and get it back up and running. But to open this, I have to break it because it's pressed all over here. So I have to break it open. Just too bad. Oh dear. Oh boy. Look inside here. You can really, really see it's full of burnt contact particles. And see, they're of course dead mounted in. See? Some nice and soft materials. Yikes. And see, this is very close to what I explained in the schematics. You've got a mass that is creating a stable oscillation. Let me see if I can get it. Yeah, it's everything here is just impossible to look at because it's completely black. See this little contact up here? That is the oscillation. See? Oscillation contact. And then the big fat ones up here. That is the transformer drive contacts. What we can't really see is the way that they move and all that kind of stuff. So all I have to do is take a little piece of paper and just put it back and forward in here. There you see some. Yeah, I think you see it. Yes, I can see some tiny little dots. And that's probably the contact point. What else can we cut this away so we can better see the whole hang on. So I tried to pull it a little bit out here, and all the wires, they just completely cracked, and I actually think it's short circuits because the wires, they were pressed very hot down here in the bottom. It's probably also running very warm. And then maybe that was a problem. Shorted wires. So let's try and run it again. Now it's open. You can see the little resonator. Wait. So it's moving quite a lot. And this is only 5 volts. Let me try and give it 6 volts. So it's really, really moving a lot. And the different voltages don't really affect the frequency. It's really all about the mass in this piece down here. Let me see if I can make a high-speed video clip. That could be fun. I'm a little bit careful about where I touch, because this contact kind of kicks back a high voltage, so I really don't like to get this through my fingers. I think I didn't explain all the details loud and clear enough about this, actually, so I think I want to connect the inductor and the sensor of that half of the contacts to positive. And I don't know if that is visible here on the video, but that's actually isolation material. So that means the part that vibrates here is actually isolated from the two contacts. I don't know if you can see that really. Yes, you can. Down here, it's isolation, right? So that means if this one here is positive, right, It's just like the schematic that I explained earlier. And then that positive goes to either that or that, alternating like that, right? So imagine the other center of the switch, that is actually our ground. Just like I've connected it, like ground. And then there is a resistor in series with the oscillator. That is not that important, by the way, but anyway. So that is ground. And now ground is connected again in perfect phase with that or that, right? So now it makes perfect sense. Why are we having two different contact sets? One that is around positive and the other one that's around ground. And I think it's quite obvious what they're trying to achieve here. Let's try and make a little schematic. So let's try and explain the two contacts. So this is the oscillator, and that will be, those two are connected together mechanically. This one is connected to ground. And then you see, this is the center point of our transformer. That's also our input, okay? So when this is oscillating, we have positive going this way, or we have positive going that way into the transformer, right? Push, pull, drive. But imagine you want to rectify in sync with your primary. All you have to do is connect the sides of your transformer via the other contact sets, and then you have a rectifier with 100% efficiency. It's amazing. So this is mechanical switch mode converter with a synchronous rectifier for super high efficiency. I mean, don't you just love it? So here's what I've done. I am using a positive sensor of that one, right? So that means the two outputs of this contact set goes positive. And I've been cleaning the contacts with a piece of paper and pressing a little bit and then moving the paper. And I actually do get decent contact now, so I can show you how it works. And I took some resistors to ground just to pull the signal down, and two channels on my scope here. And now I can show you how it looks. So this is the positive drive, and then see, there is a nice dead between the pulses to the next one. And well, the symmetry is more or less okay, isn't it? One, the purple one here, is a little bit wider, but 116, and it's because I measure this one goes low, right? And then this one goes low. So here is my 116 hertz. The scope is confused about those extra noise pulses, and of course that is causing some confusion to the internal normal way to count kind of pulses and whatnot. So that is how it is. I hope you got a little bit more clever on vibrators and mechanical switch mode power supply, synchronous rectification and all that kind of stuff, smart stuff. And thank you very much for watching, and have a good day.